Hi all, thank you for joining ZEBIX Summit Online 2021. Let's take a look at ZEBIX and the art of S&P traps. So, action is reaction. Let me first introduce myself. My name is Brian van Bakel, working as ZEBIX consultant, ZEBIX trainer, and I'm doing that at Open Source IST Solutions, and we are active in the Netherlands, United Kingdom, and United States. What we are going to talk about is SNMP, and we are focusing on a few concepts here: SNMP polling, SNMP trapping, a short explanation on how to capture SNMP traps in combination with ZEBIX, and I try to explain how to react on those traps using ZEBIX. So first things first, what is SNMP? Well, SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol, and although it's not simple, it's in the name, so I can't change it. It's introduced in the early 90s, so it's an old protocol. And currently we have three versions. Version 1, version 2C, version 3. Hopefully you won't come across version 1 too often, as it is really, really old. Version 2C seems to be the common version right now. Well, version 3 is implementing a few nice features, such as security and authentication. Hopefully, SNMP is only used to monitor network equipment such as routers, switches, firewalls, printers, applications, but not really for monitoring Linux systems or Windows systems, operating systems in general. Protocol consists out of various components: polling, trapping, commands and control. We will take a look about polling and trapping, and we will ignore the commands SNMP set in this talk. So, polling. A ZEBIX server requesting data from a remote device. So it's opening a connection, asking for a single metric, a normal SNMP GET, or many metrics in that single request. That's a GET bulk. Hopefully the device will respond on it and give back the metrics that are requested. Now, if you dive into SNMP monitoring, you will quickly see things like MIBs and OIDs. MIB, Management Information Base, so the readable format. OID is the object identifier. Here I have listed the sys uptime, and as you can see, the MIB, nice and readable. Sys uptime, time ticks, read only, with the description. If we want to query sys uptime, we can use this one, sys uptime, or we can use the numeric value .136, etc. Of course, the OID, hard to understand what's going on. The other way around, that's what we call trapping. So a remote device is pushing back data towards the ZEBIX server. Most of the times this is event driven, and event driven, things like port flaps, temperature going above a threshold or below a threshold, administrative login, configuration that is saved somewhere, I don't know, memory usage too high, CPU too high, a lot of events are pushed into ZEBIX. In order to get that going, we have a few components that should cooperate. So here on the left we have an SNMP device, and that SNMP device is pushing data towards ZEBIX. Well, in order to get that going on the ZEBIX server, we need SNMP TrapD. SNMP TrapD is the one listening on the specific port, and it is pushing it into a trap receiver. This trap receiver is processing the data, and I have an example later on, is processing the data, and once it is processed, it is written into a trap file. From there, the ZEBIX SNMP trapper will pick it up, push it into the ZEBIX server daemon, and from there it will be made visible in your ZEBIX frontend. How does those things look in ZEBIX? Well, if we take a look at polling, we are discovering quite some interfaces, and per interface we are getting metrics. So this is all regarding the LAN, and we are getting out various metrics. And as this is polling, there is an update interval. Every 5 minutes we are requesting those metrics, or in case of the interface type, every 4 hours. If we check how it looks with trapping, We can see there is no interval there. That's because the remote device is pushing data towards ZX. So we have two options here. We have an SNMP trap fallback. We capture all traps for this device, push it on one item. Or we capture specific traps and then using SNMP trap with the regular expression, we are actually telling ZX if you can match this regex, then it should be written on this item. If you can match another regex, then write it on that other item. So with the fallback, we have one item. With capture specific, we have one item per metric. And of course, we can combine those things. So we can tell ZX, well, try to push the traps to the accordingly items. But if that's not possible because it's another trap, push it into the fallback. If we then check the latest data and we try to compare it with a TCP dump, this is how a trap looks like. So we have a timestamp, we have an IP address where it is coming from, where it was sent to, and then the OIDs. Well, apparently this is a link up trap with an uptime. It's giving the interface index, the administrative status, and the operational status. So yeah, definitely this is a link up message because the oper status is up. Those OIDs, or this formatted raw trap, is processed and pushed into ZX. And in ZX, it might look like this. So we can clearly see where it's coming from, where it is sent to. We can see the community. And again, interface index, admin status, oper status, with some extra data as well. So this is typically how an SNMP trap looks like. Okay, so far, so good. When we are using SNMP and we are monitoring network equipment, we want to keep the polling interval as low as possible. All polls, all polling requests should be handled by CPU on those network devices, and typically they don't really like it. So we keep the polling interval as low as possible, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, for some types of information, even once per few hours, once per day, as low as possible. Yet we want traps to get fast status updates. Because those traps are event driven, they are pushed into ZX within a second after something happened on that device. So it's giving you very fast a status update. There is only one catch. If you rely on traps only, you might miss information. SNMP is based on UDP protocol, and that means that the device will send the traps, but it doesn't really care if they are received or not. They are pushed out and that's it. There it all stops. So yeah, if you miss a trap for whatever reason, then unfortunately you won't know. And yeah, ZX won't complain, of course, because there is no default update interval per trap. Okay, if we combine those two ideas there, what if we tell ZX, if you receive a trap, only then I want to get all other information as well, so that we have a fast status update of the whole device and not only the event. Like I already mentioned, you don't want to set the polling to every few seconds because probably the device is not capable of handling it. So we need a different mechanism. Well, it's built in already. If you go to configuration host, find the correct host, you can select all SNMP items and hit that execute now button. Within a few seconds, the ZX server will start reaching out to those devices or getting those metrics. And that means within seconds, you have that up-to-date status. But of course, if a trap is sent, you do not really want to, well, go to your ZX frontend, find the configuration, find the correct items, hit the execute now button. You really want this to be automated. And that's possible using the ZX API. In the API, there is a nice method task dot create, and with that method we are actually selecting specific items and telling Zabbix do an execute now. So the assumption I'm making here is that your Zabbix configuration is working already, so you already have those SNMP traps coming in, you already have the polling working, and we can utilize the API. How to configure this? Well, here comes in tags. So on the trigger, and I'm talking about the trigger where SNMP traps are coming on that trigger we should have a tag, and it can basically be anything, but here I made it SNMP trap with a value of true. Severity doesn't really matter, multiple tags on this problem, on this trigger, no problem at all. We are using this tag to call an action, and within that action we will make sure API calls are executed. In order to get those API calls going, we need to authenticate. In all the versions of Zabbix, you need a username password. Starting from Zabbix 5.4, we can utilize API tokens. So that's what presented here. Go to Administration General, API tokens, and generate a new API token. As you can see, I generated it here on a dedicated user. Once the token is added, you can see it here, copy it to the clipboard and use it later on. Now that we have the tags set and the API token set, it's time to configure a front-end script. In administration scripts, create a new script, give it a name, update all items, which should be executed by an action. The type is a script, and it should be executed on the Zabbix server. And here is where it basically comes together, because in this script we are telling Zabbix execute a Python script. This Python script is in a certain directory, and we are pushing in the host name of the involved host. Is it really coming together? Not yet. We need an action, and in that action we are telling Zabbix if a trap is received, so that trap problem was generated, then execute something. Well, in order to get that matching going, we are using tags again. Tag SNMP trap with a value of true, then do some sort of operation, and that operation is execute the front-end script we just created. Execute it just once, but do it immediately, and execute it on the host where the trap was received on. There we are. If a trap is received, this action will take place, and in this action we will try to update all items using a Python script. That Python script is not in place yet, and I'm not gonna show you how to place it, what to adjust. I'm just gonna tell you it's available on our GitHub page, and there is a dedicated repository, Zabbix update all items. Get the script from there, place it in a certain directory, user lib Zabbix front end script or whatever directory you want, and you should be fine. Update the URL, add the API token. There we are. Script is relying on Python 3, and we need Python pip in order to get the request module going. Request module is used to make those API calls. Once the script is in place, everything should be fine, and the only thing that is left is testing. So normally we have this. A Zabbix server reaching out to remote devices once per update interval. So this is polling, and it is doing it once per 15 minutes, once per few hours, once per whatever update interval you configured, and that device will respond with the correct metrics. This will take place every single time as per update interval. So normal operations, nothing is going on there. But what if a trap is received? Well, then we go to this slide. So on the right side we have an SNMP device, and yeah, something happened. It is sending an SNMP trap towards the Zabbix server. Well, SNMP trap D is capturing it, processing it, pushing it into a file. From there, the SNMP trapper will pick it up and it will be available for your SEBEX server daemon. Because it was received by the SEBEX server daemon, the trigger we just configured goes into the problem state. Because the trigger goes into the problem state, an action takes place, and that action is calling that Python script. In that Python script, we have that execute now action automated. So the Python script will actually create new tasks for your SEBEX server in order to pull all metrics on that particular device. And that's exactly what's going to happen in step number 5. There is an immediate pull sequence going on, requesting metrics from that SNMP device. And within seconds after receiving the SNMP trap, we know the exact state of that device because of all those polling going on. I think this is a nice combination. Because of the polling, we have our frequent updates, but they are slow. Because of the SNMP traps, we just make sure that we receive them. And immediately after receiving it, we request a full status update on that remote host. So that's basically it. It's not too complicated. It is a nice, easy integration to get things going within SEBEX and reacting on traps. What we have created right now is just an get all metrics. But of course, utilizing those tags, you can tell SEBEX to get out only a subset of metrics. It's not included in the script, but it's not really too hard to get it going. So like I said, that's it. I think if there are any questions, this is the time.